Al-Houthi in support of Palestine. Al-Houthi to coalition of aggression, our patience will run out. The leader of Ansar Allah affirms that the movement will not squander the achievements of the Yemeni people in terms of freedom and independence. The leader of Ansar Allah movement, Sayyid Abdul Malik Al-Houthi, said that the stage we're in Yemen is a stage of war, and what's calmed down is none but military escalation, pointing out that we are today in the position of confronting targeting and threats as the stage of just following up on the news of the attacks on our nation has come to an end. Al-Houthi warned and advised the coalition of aggression that patience will run out as we cannot accept depriving our people of their national wealth. He added on the occasion of the martyrdom anniversary of Hussein Badr al-Din al-Houthi today, Friday, we're currently going through a de-escalation phase under Omani mediation and intensive efforts to stop the aggression on Yemen. He also thanked the Omanis for their efforts and stressed the necessity of addressing the humanitarian and livelihood file, which we can barter or remain silent about. The Yemeni leader affirmed that we'll not squander the achievements of our people in terms of freedom, independence, and maintaining dignity, stressing that in any dialogue to be held, the main point should be that enemies must end their aggression against our country. He warned that time may run out and we may return to pressure options to obtain our people's rights to their wealth. If peace is what they want, its path is clear. Its key is solving the humanitarian file, and its ultimate goal is to end the aggression. Enemies provide all kinds of weapons, including nuclear weapons. The leader of Ansar Allah movement said the Americans and Western countries occupy countries and appoint puppet governments therein to suppress anyone who opposes their hegemony. Al-Houthi added that the Americans and their affiliates violate the sovereignty of states and their ambassadors meddle in everything, both issuing directives as if they're the rulers of the countries in question. The Americans are the ones that launch military attacks and aggression, such as their invasion of Iraq and in Afghanistan, their aggression against Yemen, and their occupation of Palestine. The Yemeni leader said, adding that they do their best to destabilize the security of our nation through the founding of Takfiri groups and exerting pressure on the country's regime to facilitate their operations. In this context, he reaffirmed that the Takfiri groups are made by the West and America with the aim of distorting the image of Islam. The Yemeni leader indicated that the enemies provide all kinds of weapons, including nuclear weapons, to hostile countries, whereas the countries that come under attack are denied any such weapons. Al-Houthi affirmed, they want us to be a nation deprived of any ability to defend itself, and that's why they're working to ban the supply of weapons to any country they want to target. He further added that the enemies impose agents and ignorant individuals on peoples and in important positions in state institutions with the aim of inflicting as much damage on them as possible and controlling them, thus forcing people to yield. Absenting the Palestinian cause to wipe out the people's memory. The Ansar Allah leader pointed out that the enemies exerted strained efforts to keep the Palestinian cause out of the school curricula and were keen to exclude anything that could advance the nation's level of awareness. He considered that all forms of injustice and criminal activities are imposed on the Palestinian people on a daily basis. The Americans are the main killers of women and have killed millions of them simultaneously as the crimes of killing women continue in Palestine at the hands of the Israelis, Sayyid Al-Houthi stressed. He confirmed that we're ready to intervene on the side of our Palestinian people and ready for all possibilities, stressing that anyone who cooperates and normalizes relations within the Israeli enemy will face serious consequences. Targeting culture and intellect. Al-Houthi also said the enemies are committed to assassinating leaders in Yemen, Lebanon, Syria, and Iraq, and supporting dictatorial and repressive regimes to ensure their subordination. The Yemeni leader stressed that the enemies target the nation in the most dangerous forms as they carry out attacks on the cultural and intellectual levels, noting that under the title of freedom of expression, they apply systematic plans and mechanisms to take a hit at all Islamic sanctities, foremost of which is undermining the sanctity of the Quran among Muslims. Sayyid Al-Houthi pointed out that the Americans and the West are pressuring the Arab and Islamic regimes to change the laws derived from Islamic law in order to create an opinion environment for unhindered crimes. The move of the martyred leader, Hussein Badr al-Din, came at a time when American-Israeli hegemony entered a new phase under trumped-up titles, he further stressed. The enemies worked on cultural invasion or spreading the so-called American liberalism in a way that contradicts Islamic values, the Ansar Allah leader said, adding that the enemies used newspapers and websites to this end. U.S. punishes people through blockades and sanctions. Houthi touched on the U.S. military bases in the region, saying that the American imposing military bases to extend control over our countries while the United Nations and the Security Council are biased against the people of our nation and all their positions are in favor of their enemies or the enemies. He called the blockade one of the biggest crimes, indicating that it amounts to a collective punishment of peoples and starvation of societies. Regarding the economic inflation witnessed in some countries, the Yemeni leader explained that the enemies impose economic pressures and deprive the people of their national wealth, explaining that they were keen through the dollar to control the wealth of the people and steal their goods. They practice the economic blockade to punish any country that rejects from their subordination, he said. Saeed al-Houthi pointed out that the Americans seize countries' funds by freezing their assets through their sanctions, noting that this happened with many countries, including Yemen. He continued, the enemies of the nation aim to strike domestic and agricultural production and to prevent achieving self-sufficiency with the aim of keeping us living on imports. Elsewhere in his remarks, Saeed al-Houthi offered his condolences to the Syrian and Turkish peoples for the earthquake victims, condemning the U.S. blockade on Syria and the fragility of Arab humanitarian cooperation. And this from Al-Masira. The leader of the revolution, Saeed Abdul Malik al-Houthi, affirmed on Friday that Yemen's now in stage of war and that only some military escalation has stopped. On the martyrdom anniversary of Saeed Hussein Badreddin al-Houthi, Saeed Abdul Malik said, we're in a state of continuous war, not in a truce agreement, and there's a reduction in escalation in the light of an Omani mediation. He added, we thank the brothers in the Sultanate of Oman who deal with us with the principle of good neighborliness, and we appreciate their efforts and seek to give them a sufficient opportunity for the success of their endeavors. Saeed Abdul Malik reaffirmed that in all dialogues, we cannot ignore the humanitarian issue as a priority. He pointed out that when we allow continuation of our negotiations and dialogues, this doesn't mean that we'll continue indefinitely, warning by saying time may run out and we may return to pressing options to obtain our people's right to their wealth. Saeed Abdul Malik explained that one of the steps we're taking at the current stage is to prevent the plundering of the oil wealth and prevent its export abroad and the theft of its price. And we succeeded thanks to Allah in that. He also stressed that in any negotiations, we'll not accept neglecting the achievements and gains of our people regarding freedom, independence, and dignity. And these are the red lines that we cannot neglect. Saeed Abdul Malik stressed that the course of any dialogue or agreement must lead to the withdrawal of the occupation forces and the prevention of interference in our internal affairs. Regarding the Palestinian issue, Saeed Abdul Malik said, the Palestinian people suffer from the enemy's escalation and meet it with sacrifice, steadfastness, and disturbing martyrdom operations for the enemy. Explaining that the Israeli enemy is heading for more settlements, land confiscation, torture of prisoners, and daily violations against Al-Aqsa Mosque. He stressed that we as the Yemeni people are ready for all possibilities in Palestine, saying if intervention of our Islamic peoples is required, we're ready to intervene on the side of our Palestinian people, and I hope that there will be a willingness for that. And he considered that whoever cooperates with the Israeli enemy is a partner in violating the rights of the Palestinian people and attacking and oppressing them, explaining by saying, at a time when the enemy continues its crimes against the Palestinian people, the regimes that normalize with Israel tend more to strengthen their relations with it, and this is a disgrace. And here's Press TV's take on that. Takfiri terrorist groups created by U.S. and its allies, al-Houthi. The leader of Yemen's Ansarullah popular resistance movement considers Takfiri terrorist groups to be constructs of the U.S. and its allies. The terror outfits have been created by the West, including the U.S. and the Israeli regime, which is Washington's closest ally, Abdul Malik al-Houthi said during an address on Friday. By creating political crises, the enemies are trying to preoccupy nations and distance them from the path of productivity and progress, he asserted. Takfiri terrorist outfits, most notably among them Daesh, unleashed a campaign of bloodletting and destruction in Syria and neighboring Iraq in 2014 as the U.S. was running out of excuses to extend or enlarge its regional meddling. The U.S. and its allies invaded Syria later the same year under the pretext of fighting Daesh. The U.S.-led military interference was, however, surprisingly slow in confronting the terrorists. Despite the sheer size of the coalition that enlisted scores of Washington allied countries, numerous reports and regional officials would meanwhile point to the U.S.'s role in transferring Daesh elements throughout the region and even airlifting supplies to the terror outfit. War for profit, Houthi consider the United States to be responsible for sowing warfare and sedition across other nations so it can help American arms manufacturers profiteer from pouring weapons into the targeted countries. Arrogant powers enable the deployment of banned arms across several spots throughout the region, including in Palestine and Yemen, thus committing genocide, he said. Houthi was referring to the U.S. and its allies' sales of those weapons, such as white phosphorus and cluster bombs, to their proxies, including the Israel regime and Saudi Arabia, for deployment in the targeted locations. He, however, warned, "Gone are the days when we would only listen to the news about acts of encroachment against other nations. Now we have entered the period of taking responsibility versus nations and confronting the dangers that threaten them." Advice towards regional unity. The Ansar Allah leader advised regional countries to avoid playing into the enemy's hands by letting them benefit from the nation's internal differences. 90% of the enemy's plots against us take place through their exploiting the very internal differences, he said, or he stressed, enumerating other means of U.S.-led interference in other countries, especially those of the region. Houthi warned that the Americans impose their mercenaries and ignorant officials on other nations as a means of delivering heavy blows to them. By infiltrating their mercenaries into various positions of responsibility and institutions that are in charge of running countries' economic affairs, the enemies would seek to carry out sabotage operations across the targeted nations, cautioned the Ansar Allah leader. "The biggest problem that our nations are suffering from is the persons that are submissive towards America," he said. And finally, from Tazneem, Yemen's Ansar Allah leader, U.S. allies created Takfiri terrorist groups. Takfiri terrorist groups have been formed by the U.S. and its allies, leaders of Yemen's Ansar Allah popular resistance movement, Abdul Malik al-Houthi said. The terrorist outfits have been created by the West, including the U.S. and the Israeli regime, which is Washington's closest ally, Houthi said during an address on Friday. "By creating political crises, the enemies are trying to preoccupy nations in distance them from the path of productivity and progress," he asserted. Takfiri terrorists outfit, most notably among them Daesh, ISIL, or ISIS, unleashed a campaign of bloodletting and destruction in Syria and neighboring Iraq in 2014 as the U.S. was running out of excuses to extend or enlarge its regional meddling. The U.S. and its allies invaded Syria later the same year under the pretext of fighting Daesh. The U.S.-led military interference was, however, surprisingly slow in confronting these terrorists, despite the sheer size of the coalition that had enlisted scores of Washington allied countries. Numerous reports in the regional officials would meanwhile point to the U.S.'s role in transferring Daesh elements throughout the region and even airlifting supplies to the terror outfit. Houthi considered the United States to be responsible for sowing warfare and sedition across other nations so it can help American arms manufacture profiteer from pouring weapons into the targeted countries. Watch this space. Arrogant powers enable the deployment of banned arms across several spots throughout the region, including Palestine and Yemen, thus committing genocide. Houthi was referring to the U.S. and its allies' sales of those weapons, such as white phosphorus and cluster bombs, to their proxies, including the Israel regime and Saudi Arabia, for deployment in the targeted locations. He, however, warned, "Gone are the days when we would only listen to the news about acts of encroachment against other nations. Now we've entered the period of taking responsibility versus nations and confronting the dangers that threaten them." The Ansar Allah leader advised regional countries to avoid